Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. In today's video, episode 15 of the Kasparov series. We are in 1980 in Dortmund and Kasparov is playing the Junior World Championship. In the last episode we watched this fantastic victory in round 1 against the Dutch champion Cuijpers. Today we are going to watch his game from round 6 against Ralf Akesson that will later become a grandmaster. Let's start with the game. Kasparov with the white pieces opens with d4. Here comes knight to f6, c4, e6, and now knight to f3. With b6, we enter the Queen's Indian defense. And Kasparov continues with a3. This is the Petrosian system. There are a lot of moves, a lot of good moves that black can play, but bishop to b7 is the most played. Here comes knight to c3, and now d5. C captures on d5. With knight recaptures on d5 instead of e captures on d5, white has this mobile center, but black can opt to open the long diagonal for this good bishop. Here comes e3, of course, opening the diagonal for the bishop on f1. In my opinion, in this position, to improve the strength of this bishop, black should play knight captures on c3. Let's watch this variation and later let's go back to our game. So, knight captures on c3, in my opinion, quite interesting to try, not played during the game. Here comes b captures on c3, and now bishop to d6, bishop to d3, short castle, and here comes e4. Now, with the immediate c5, black is perfectly fine and in practical play scores very well. Let's go back to our game. After Kasparov continues with e3, here comes bishop to e7, and bishop to b5 we check. c6, bishop back to d3, and now knight to d7. e4 with tempo against the knight, knight captures on c3, and the b-pawn recaptures on c3. Here comes c5, so opening this diagonal and also attacking the center, short castle for white, and c captures on d4. C captures on d4, short castle also for black, but white has the advantage because Kasparov is controlling the center and also has the space advantage. The next goal is to find the optimal squares for the other pieces and then to attack the enemy king. Here comes queen to e2, rook to c8, bishop to b2, watching the king side, queen to c7, and if now rook to c1 there is queen to f4, that is good. So here comes queen to e3 controlling f4, knight to f6, and with knight to e5, the game is original. This is a good move. The knight is blocking e5, and Kasparov is ready to push with f4. Here comes b5, and this is a great move because the bishop cannot capture the pawn, and here is the counterplay and the try by the black player to gain some space because the bishop cannot capture or e4 is lost. So here comes f4. Queen to b6 on the same diagonal of the queen and the king. So king to h1, b4, and with b3, black has the passed pawn. So a captures on b4, bishop recaptures, and rook in a goes to b1, watching the queen. There is also the idea of bishop to a3. So here comes a5, good move. Queen to e2, that is preventing bishop to a6. This Kasparov is really strong because during the attack it takes time to prevent all those moves that is changing pieces will reduce the strength of this attack. So preventing bishop to a6 with the idea of changing this important white bishop. So here comes queen to a7 away from the b-file, and now f5. With queen to a8 there is more pressure against the center, and this is an important moment of the game. Kasparov continues with d5, but later he criticized much this move because this is the first and probably the only inaccuracy that he played during the game. Let's go back one move. This position, analyzing the game after the match, Kasparov found that f captures on e6 is the best move, and in this position there are some lines to consider, so sorry if I will lose some time in this position. So, after f captures on e6, Black is forced to recapture, because let's watch what happens after bishop captures on e4. Here comes e captures on f7, we check. Now, if rook captures on f7, there is bishop captures on e4, and of course, when and if the knight will recapture, then this rook is lost. So after e captures on f7, the only other move is king to h8. Now rook captures on f6 is enough to win the game, because now this bishop is under attack. Bishop captures on g2, we check. There is king to g1, the rook is lost, but queen to f2 is attacking the bishop, but more than that, is threatening checkmate in 1, capturing on f6. So let's go back to our f captures on e6. So it's clear that black must recapture. So f captures on e6, here comes d5, e captures on d5, and knight to g4, three pieces attacking f6. Now in this position, not knight captures on e4, because there is the beautiful knight to h6, we check. Again, only two possible moves, with g captures on h6. There is bishop captures on e4, and nothing can stop the checkmate on g4 sooner or later, because now, of course, if d captures on e4, it's already checkmate. So after knight to h6, we check. The other possible move again is king to h8, knight to f7, we check. If now king to g8, there is bishop captures on e4, d captures, queen to g4. Now again, there is the checkmate threat. So the rook is forced to capture, rook captures, king captures. Now queen to d7, pushing the king to the corner, bishop to e7, shielding the king, doesn't work, because there is rook to f1, we check, the king is forced to move away. Queen captures on e7, and again, the checkmate threat is here on g7. Let's go back to knight to h6, we check. King to h8, knight to f7, we check. If now rook captures on f7, there is rook recaptures, and again, the winning maneuver is queen to g4. So let's go back to our game. We said after queen to a8, putting more pressure to the center, here comes the only inaccuracy, d5, e captures on d5, and now knight to g4, knight captures, queen captures. So if possible, Kasparov will play f6, weakening the dark squares around the king. So here comes f6, good move. Now if e5, there is bishop to c3, blocking the diagonal. So in this position, Kasparov thought for 45 minutes, and then, boom, bishop captures on f6. The pawn is pinned, cannot, of course, recapture. So the only capture is rook captures on f6. But now e5 comes with tempo, rook to h6, f6 now, again, the pawn is pinned. Rook to c7, protecting g7, but here comes e6, queen to d8. e7 with tempo, rook captures on e7 is the only possible capture, because if bishop captures, there is checkmate. So with the rook capture, of course, the change is lost, but the rook is protecting g7. Here comes f captures on e7 and queen captures on e7. Rook in b goes to c1, there is this terrible idea, rook to c8, bishop capture, queen capture, and even if the queen interposed, this rook is controlling f7, so becomes checkmate. So queen back to d8, protecting the back rank, but here comes queen to f5, queen to b8, queen to f7, we check, king to h8, and after rook to c7, attacking everything and threatening checkmate in 1, black resigns, because the only move is queen to g8, but of course, after rook captures on b7, Kasparov is a rook up for two isolated pawns. So it was another fantastic attacking game with a classic Kasparov idea, a piece sacrifice to be able to advance two advanced, connected, and also central pawns to win the game. I really hope that you liked this video. If you did, please don't forget to like the video and to subscribe to the channel. For now, I thank you very much for watching, and see you tomorrow. Goodbye!